Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's video, I'm going to be showing you how I make my Nigerian party jollof rice. So as you can see, this jollof rice looks so yummy and very inviting. So if today is the first time of stopping by or coming across my video, you are highly welcome. Please do well to click on the like and subscribe button. After that, turn on the notification bell so that I get notified each time I upload a new video. And for my returning subscribers, you guys are highly appreciated. If you want to know how I make this jollof rice, stay tuned and keep on watching. So for our ingredients, first of all, we'll be needing our fresh tatashe, fresh tomatoes, sweet long pepper, onions, and scald bonnet pepper. So over here I have 10 pieces of tatashe here. The tatashe is very small. If you have the big one, you can use 3 or 4. It will go well with it. Okay, so I have 2 purple onions. These onions I'm going to be blending it with my tomatoes, and I have scotch bonnet pepper as well. So, and I have sweet long pepper, okay, and I'm going to be using 4 tomatoes as well. So I'm going to be blending everything together. All right, so I'll blend everything together, and I have my garlic and ginger here. So I have garlic as well. Okay, so what I'm going to be doing right now, I'm going to be removing all the seed from my tatashe. Okay, so when you want to blend your tatashe, you don't need to blend the seed with it. So I'll just cut it and take out the seed inside the tatashe. So as you can see what I'm doing right now, I'm just trying to take out all the seed inside the tatashe out. So after taking it out, I'll blend everything together, and I will steam my tomatoes before I start my cooking process. Steaming your tomatoes before you use it to make your jollof rice is very important. It will give your jollof rice a very unique and special taste, okay? Always make sure you steam your tomato before you use it. Alright guys, welcome back. So this is after 30 minutes. So this is my rice that I'm going to be using. So I'm using 2 cups of rice. So that is 2 dirica of rice. That is what I have here. And I have some flour oil. And I have my medium size of tomato paste, and this is my tomatoes that I blend. So I've already steamed it. That is the final product of it. So I have bay leaf here. So over here is my chicken stock. I've already seasoned my chicken overnight. Yeah, so this is my chicken, and this is the stock that I got from the chicken that I fried. All right, so I have my butter here. Okay, so over here are my seasoning. This is my paprika, chicken seasoning, all-purpose seasoning, mavina, onga, curry powder, thyme, and the rosemary, and my seasoning cube, okay, and my salt to taste. So I've already put my pot on the stove. So I'm add 1 onions to it. So after adding my onions, I will stir it. I'm going to stir it for at least 2 to 3 minutes for the onions to release its flavor inside my oil. Okay, so this is about 2 minutes. I'm adding my curry powder, my thyme, and my rosemary inside my oil. So I'll fry it together, fry it for like a minute. So after like about 1 minute, I'm going to be introducing my tomato paste to it. So after adding my tomato paste, I'm going to be frying this stew for at least 5 to 10 minutes for my tomato paste to fry. So it's important to fry your tomato paste so that if the tomato paste has this sour taste, you will get rid of it before adding your fresh tomatoes to it. So I'm going to be frying this for at least 5 to 10 minutes, okay? So this is like about 10 minutes now. So I'm going to be adding my tomatoes to it, okay? So after adding my tomatoes, I will fry it for another 10 good minutes before adding other ingredients to it. So guys, this is after 10 minutes, so I'm going to be adding my other spices, okay? So first of all, I'm going to be adding my stock cube. After adding my stock cube, I'll add the other ingredients, my spicy tea, my mevina, my onga, my chicken seasoning. So I'll add everything to it and I'll mix it until everything is well combined. Okay, so after mixing everything together, next I'm going to be adding my chicken stock to it. Okay, so this is my chicken stock, so I'll add my chicken stock to it and I'll mix everything together until it is well combined. As our stew is cooking, we'll go straight to go and wash our rice now, okay? So this stage I'm going to be washing my rice proper, okay? I'll wash my rice until my water that I used to wash the rice is white, until you will not see that cream color inside your rice before you know that yes, your rice is clean. So I wash my rice like about 5 to 6 times, all right? So as you can see, the water that is coming out from it is white. That shows that my rice is well clean, all right? So let's go and check our stew. So guys, my stew has been cooking now for at least 10 minutes. So I'll just stir it together. So you continue stirring it to avoid your stew not to get burnt, okay? So after stirring it for some time, so I'm going to be transferring my rice to it. So I'll pour my rice to it. I'll mix everything together until it is well combined. After mixing it proper, I'm going to be adding some water to it. So I'll add water to it and I'll stir it to see if I need to add more or not, okay? I needed to add water, so I'm going to be adding a little bit of water to it as well. So when you want to cook your rice, you want to achieve a perfect party jollof rice, you don't need to overcrowd your pot with water, okay? Just add little. This little will go a very long way. So what I'm going to be doing right now, I will just test it to see. This is the right time for you to test for seasoning, for your salt. So after this time, you don't need to add anything to your rice again. So mine was okay. So the next thing, I added my bay leaf to it. So after adding my bay leaf, I will just mix it proper and I will cover it with a very low heat. You don't over high your cooker when you are making your rice this stage. So I will lower my cooker and I will allow it to cook. So I cover it. I cook this rice for 20 to 25 minutes. Yeah, so this is after 25 minutes, this is what we got, okay? So do you see that? So I'm going to be stirring it together so I'll stir it together so that the heat will circulate the pot very well, okay? After stirring it together, so I tested it, my rice was still strong, so I needed to use this foil paper to cover it. So I'll cover it with this foil paper, so I will allow the heat to cook the rice at this stage. So you don't need to high your heat at this stage, just lower your heat, and your heat is going to do the remaining job for you. Alright, so I cover this rice for another 15 good minutes with my foil paper. Alright guys, this is after 15 good minutes. Wow, this is after 15 good minutes. Our rice is ready. At this stage, my rice was very, very soft. Alright, as you can see, so the color right now will tell you that my rice is perfectly okay. So I'll just mix everything together. So I'm going to be stirring it so that my rice will not burn, all right? Did you see that? See how beautiful our rice is, okay? So this stage, I'm going to be adding my other ingredients to it, like my sliced onions and my fresh tomatoes. And I'm going to be adding butter to it as well. So this butter that I'm adding right now will give my rice that shiny, that gorgeous look. All right, that shiny look that you will see when you go to party. That is what our butter is going to give to our rice. So at this stage, I will just stir it proper. I'll just stir it, mix everything together. So if you don't want to add your tomatoes and your onions at this moment, you can as well just serve your rice this way. It's perfectly okay. So I'm just using these onions and tomatoes to garnish it, to give it that special touch, okay? So if you don't have tomatoes to add it at this stage, don't worry, just serve your jollof rice like that. It's perfectly okay. It's good to go. Alright, so you don't need to add your onions if you don't want to add it. So you don't need to add your tomatoes if you don't want to add it as well. So after stirring it proper, so I'm just going to cover it because of my butter, so that my butter will melt proper on my rice, okay? So I'll just cover it for at least 2 to 3 good minutes, okay? So after 2 to 3 good minutes, our rice is ready, guys, okay? So thank you all so much for watching. If you have watched to this extent, okay, you have not subscribed, please kindly click on the right button to subscribe. After that, turn on the notification bell so that you get notified each time I upload a new video. You'll be the first to be notified. And for my returning subscribers, you guys are highly, highly appreciated. I love you all so much. Thank you for clicking in to watch today's video. So our rice is ready. Do you see after 10 minutes, after 2 minutes, sorry. So our rice is perfectly okay. Let me move the camera close so that you see it very well. So guys, our rice is ready. So thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all in my next video. Enjoy the rest of this video, okay?